I'm not. I'm afraid that Chad's dead.
No, he's not. He's brave.
Yeah, but maybe he's in jail.
No, he'll be back after 6 months, after the war's over. Now let's go make some bread.
Okay.
I'll get the dough that I made last night, and you get the flour.
Okay, let's go.
Sarah builds a fire.
You got any bear grease? That's the best for this sort of hurt.
No, Bob, you're tallow.
Not as good as bear grease.
The next morning, Sarah heats water and helps Sam soak his leg. Sam sleeps most of the day.
What are you up to?
I don't remember your name.
Making a crutch?
You want to get rid of me, don't you? I can see that.
A crutch will give you something to get around on.
I'm not going to get anywhere, crutch or no crutch. I'm in too bad of a shape.
Later, Sarah took Sam vengeance.
My first wife, Brenna, had a way of picking venison you might want to learn about someday.
Okay.
Sarah gathered acorns, about 3 bushels of them. Sarah cleaned out gourds of the biggest 12 that she could find and filled them with flowers. Sarah shot 2 doves in 1 shot with her musket. Sarah then made out a bed of pine boughs laced with mosses and rushes. 5 days straight, Sarah brought in firewood for her during all the long days of winter. Sarah thought about shooting a bear, but decided against it. Sarah then thinks back to on the farm when her brother shot a bear and how she helped him dress the carcass. Sarah killed me, and she did not have any bad feelings about it. Sarah pegged my hide on the cave wall, and some foxes drug my hide away. The white bat was comforting to Sarah. She liked having it around. Sarah also decided the day would be November 7th, and she would keep track of this date.
That girl we met today, it's so sad because she lives all by herself. She knows nothing about the wilderness. We have to help her.
We help her? You have canoe?
No.
Can we build you one?
You need better door?
Yeah.
The door took a day to build, and then we helped her fish from the lake.
Thank you.
Bye.
See you next spring. We'll help you plant.
As we waved goodbye, I thought, I'm going to miss that girl.
Staring at the girl, Sarah, who's staring at me. She would look away and look right back at me. She's climbing up on me and was heading straight for the snake's den. I tried to warn her by moving, but she just kept climbing. She wouldn't stop to look back or anything. She just wanted to get to the top. She put her hand in the den, being daring, and that's when the snake attacked.
Ow! Ah!
She didn't know what to do right away. It hurt too bad to do anything, so she just climbed down. That was the last thing I saw. But then she went back to her cave.
Closer to me.
She came into the cave holding her hand. It was really strange.
Ah, I think I have to suck out the venom.
I watched her as she sucked it out. After that, she just laid on the floor holding her hand. She drank some tea. After that, she fell asleep, but I could hear her screaming in her sleep. Later the next day, she told me about her nightmare she had. The bat found out that the nightmare was about Sarah getting killed by the bear.
Mr.
Bree's going to be waiting outside his mill tonight with a gun.
Why would he do that?
Because someone's been breaking in every night at midnight.
And he thinks it's me, does he, Pete?
Yes, he does. And he also wants to know why we can't afford one bag of meal. I wonder too sometimes. Are you hiding money somewhere?
Maybe, perhaps.
So you are.
Okay, yes I am. It's not money, it's silver, and I'm never going to tell you where it's at.
Why not?
Because you may tell Birdsall and his gang sometime when they've been looking for it.
I heard the bishops had a picture of King George hanging on their wall.
We should go do something to them.
Yeah, good idea.
Let's go now when they won't expect us.
Yeah, but what are we going to do to them?
We should tar the other Mr. Bishop and burn the house and barn down.
Okay, but let's tie their girl to a tree too.
Good thinking. Let's go.
Open it up!
What do you want?
I want to talk. We can't do it through the door.
Light the candle.
We don't need light.
So, I heard you have a picture of King George hanging up.
I did have, but it's there no longer.
That's good to hear.
Where are you going?
Beyond.
Wherever you go, this will help.
Put me down.
It's Brown Bet. It's yours for £2.
Okay.
Here's your gun. There you go. You ever shot a gun?
No.
Well, I'll teach you how.
Please put me down. Ow, that hurt. Why did you do that?
She was going to leave the meeting early, so she headed towards the roof. She began to run, then a hand reached out and grabbed her.
Let me go!
Hurry, go and cut the buckets. When you're done, run and drop your knives.
Okay. Oh, gosh, what happened? Someone set the church on fire and spread to all the other buildings.
Run!
Look, someone dropped the knife.
I wouldn't pick that up if I was you.
Why shouldn't I?
Do what you want.
I think I will.
You're under arrest.
Oh, Sarah, what has happened?
First of all, his army started by their dad, and then they burned the house down.
Okay, well, where is that? We need to clean him up and bring him back to our house.
He's over there.
How do I know if it's playing or not?
Back and farther.
I'll run it.
27, okay.
No talking, guys.
Yeah. The musker is walking around, trying to remember the directions to the pond. Okay, I need to take a left turn by this tree, and then another left by the big rock. Then I should be there, thought the muskrat. What are all these metal things doing around here? Sarah was walking in the morning, getting ready to go fishing, and she sees the muskrat and the bear trap.
Oh my goodness, you poor little thing.
The muskrat didn't want Sarah around him, so he showed her his teeth. What is this ugly thing? Sarah gets the muskrat out of the trap, and the muskrat crawls to the cave. Sarah made some leftover salmon and gave it to him with water. I don't think it's safe to eat, the muskrat thought. The muskrat didn't touch the food, and Sarah picked up the Bible and read some Bible verses. I wonder if I could stay with this lady. Then Sarah puts down the Bible.
What are you doing here?
She stands in front of the muskrat and tries to make it to leave. Trust me, lady, I'm going to stay here for a while.
Sarah entered the store and didn't look like she had any money at all on her. Mr. Purdy thought to himself.
Well, what can I do for you, Sarah?
I'm not here to beg for food.
Well, maybe you have a shilling or two, maybe. A pound note? Let's see here.
Well, nothing until the corn gets in.
I had to bring the bag out for her. It was a real hassle. It was so heavy that I groaned, Mr. Purdy thought to himself.
Well, surely it can't be too heavy. Well, not for a man like you lifting it.
Well, for the...
For the past few nights, the machines have been stopping. By the way, my name's Jim Corn.
My dad is good with machines. Maybe he can fix it.
It's not the machine's problem. It's something unnatural.
After that, Sarah left the mill.
Why'd you give her something? She's a Tory.
Well, she's a customer. I have to.
That's it.
Sarah earned money at Mrs. Dorphy's Tavern. Then she came over to the Morn and Sun store.
Set off to New York early the next morning. I'll lose a tidy sum if you go off running off in the middle of most business we've ever had. Besides, this is no time for a young girl to be running around New York City by herself.
I have a letter from Major Sterling. It'll protect me.
Sarah leaves the line of lamp.
It was a bright and cool morning when Sarah set off. A sleepy-eyed girl was scrubbing the steps of the Red Line. Mr. Pennywell told Sarah that her brother might be in the old sugar warehouse down the street where the British were holding prisoners. Four soldiers with red coats and white leggings were walking up and down in front of the building with muskets on their shoulders.
We might have your brother here. What is his name?
Chad Bishop.
He's a prisoner here.
Sarah gave the officer money to buy extra rations for a month.
Sit down. I made a mistake. I thought your brother was a prisoner of mine. I found out that he is not. You are under arrest by Captain